Welcome, everyone. In this presentation, I'll provide an overview of some of the achievements as a part of the European Project Diamond. The project is focused on revealing fair and actionable knowledge from data to support women's inclusion in transport system. We consider women as users and women as employees. So about Diamond. About Diamond, the project focused on 4 years cases where inclusiveness is currently a central issue. Railway and public multimodal transport is the first use case. The second is the user experience in autonomous vehicles. And the third is bike sharing. And the last one is fairness and inclusions for employment in transport organizations. Diamond is considering women as a polyhedral individual with different characteristics that impact their experience as users and as employees of public transport. In cooperation with Tingo, we identified all characteristics that could be potential generator of inequities when the woman is facing the transport system. The achievements of Diamond can be divided in two parts: the analysis of users and employees' preferences through the dynamic argumentative Delphi, and the second is the analysis of service providers' infrastructures and the user satisfaction that will be done through a selection of infrastructure for more in-depth observation and assessment. An analysis of data collected through social media, and the analysis of user satisfaction index. I'll focus my presentation in this last one today. So now I want to show the results that we were able to get from the responses of Ferrocarrils de la Generalitat users in Barcelona. For this use case, we have results from Ferrocarrils. We represent in the project the Southern European Railway, where we collected responses from a total of 425 transport users, where was asked for males, females, non-binary, people with a big range of age, with different characteristics, and we collected data about their demographic characteristics as briefly summarized in this slide. The survey was conducted in person, on train and stations previously selected. The survey took around 15 minutes to complete. Approximately 50 questions covered the following topics: capability of meeting required needs, the accessibility of the service, and the safe and security. About the capability, the survey aimed to assess the capability of the service and the capability of the organization to meet the required needs of transport users. The capability was assessed by a series of questions that evaluator assessed the user's ability to travel in an appropriately designed transport system that meet basic expectation and was environmental sound. The means of each question by gender represented in this slide. There is evidence that the male and female respondents' needs are generally being met by these public transport service. And also, there is some discrepancy in mean scores across gender for each statement. Correlational analysis didn't show significant difference between the gender. And we would like to note as well that the number of non-binary respondents was quite small in this sample, and this can impact data analysis for this group. The survey aimed about the accessibility topic. The survey aimed to assess the accessibility of the organization for transport users. Accessible theme was assessed by a series of questions that evaluate the user's ability to access activities and services that people have reason to value, accessible for all groups in terms of design and comfort provided. For example, those traveling with children, in terms of fares and costs for those with lower income. Also, we can see there is some discrepancy in mean scores across gender. For each statement, the correlation analysis didn't show significant difference between gender except for one statement. This was, I can easily get to my destination from the station by walking or using other means of transport, in which men rating less agreement with this statement than women and non-binary transport users. The survey about the safe and secure aimed to evaluate the safety and security of the organization for users transport users. Safe and secure firm was assessed by a series of questions that evaluate or assess the user's ability to travel safely and securely using the public transport system. The means of each question by gender are presented in this slide. And also there is some discrepancy in mean score across gender for each statement. The correlation analysis didn't show this significant difference between the genders, except for one statement. This statement said, when arriving at or leaving the station, I feel safe at any time of the day. In this statement, the non-binary users disagree more with the statement that the cisgender users. And now let's move quickly into some ideas underpinning the modeling approach that we are working currently. But we have not received a big results yet, but we would like to explain. So in general, in the modeling approach, we are working towards a self-evaluation method based on the underpinning idea that also fairness and inclusivity is a characteristic that can be assessed like a quality and therefore measured, similarly to what it is done in many maturity models related to quality of the services and or safety. To get there, we are working on the following models: self-diagnosis models based on suits of observation protocols, satisfaction questionnaire, and self-audit tools. The second model is decision support system based on results obtaining from above, from the self-diagnosis model. And the third is the prediction of improvement of perceived fairness of each organization. This model will be integrated into the toolbox that will be one of our results in the next months. And finally, as a conclusion, the results are comparable across different locations, but in some way also specific to each situation or each scenario. So they need to be discussed in focus groups within each organization to help identify also more in-depth quality reason behind them and also explore possible plans for improvement. And well, hopefully in this process we will help find a suitable way to take into account women in the design of products and services and in fostering women's employability in the industry. And finally, this is all from my side. And thank you for your attention.